First thing I do when I'm approaching a battle is I open the grates, which I've held, and start extending the thralls forward and extending flaps to help them slow down. And when they finish slowing down, I will start increasing throttle. Sometimes I may increase the gear, particularly gear, or other things that help me slow down. Harry's generally pretty forgiving, so I can do that. At this point, I continue, I start doing some other shots. Sometimes it might help to reach out the throw, sometimes it might have to move out. The situation doesn't. I'm fine without SAS. It's actually pretty easy to get used to. When returning, like us, you need to deploy your rudder and then at the same time. At this point, me hitting the ground, I actually have essentially near zero damage. Maybe it's taking a amount of damage, but it can be much munitions. One thing I do when flying with the SAS, sorry, flying VTOL, is that I throw set to 1 value, which is basically 9%. I'm looking right now, so I'm going to reduce it. If I need to increase altitude, I'll just push my throttle up. Something that the Harry has that's very helpful is the ability to reverse your thrusters, which means you're able to look down your upper terrain, which is I'm going to go down to the south side. Check on my gears and whatever's up.
Attention to the map!
And I slowly vector my thrusters forward as I build speed. Once you've got 200 knots, you can go full forward, although some things like the Yaku 8 will actually just drop in those lines, so just take quarter to that. With the Yaku 8, you can set your thrusters forward and back on full flat. So when you slow down next time, you ultimately goes full back. Because the Yaku 8 does not allow you to put your throttle backwards. At this point, I'm just flying directly to the next battlefield. You have 14 rockets. I should have enough fuel and should have enough gun to kill all the kill all the tanks. I can cap Alpha when I'm finished. Capping Panzer Decoy is really easy. You just go to Alpha mode and just maintain. So I set your SAS to basically overload your Alpha. Harry does not have auto hover, but it does have auto level, and it starts as if it backwards, and the plane naturally is point slide forward in auto level. So this will, like 99% throttle angle, or 96% of that, is enough for you to hover without moving anywhere. Some DC maps have really good compensation for that fairly easily.
Just keep it up.
You can use this to tell you what your right climb is, in case you need to increase or reduce your throttle. It's quite easy. And now I'm just building speed. I'm a bit close. That's fine. I can always come back for the times I missed. Your gear down helps you bounce in case you get back to the ground. Unfortunately, you can not fire your rockets sometimes when you're too low to the ground. But having guns is able allows you to shoot attack. Your guns will allow you. I have not enough. Rocket ammo to kill attacks, but I have agents, so that's no problem. Russians will struggle. The Russians have to game aim specifically for the engine deck. And they'll allow you to kill a tank very easily. Just like that. Most tanks have basically zero armor on the engine deck, but they still have quite a health bar. So if you want to kill a tank, you have to shoot it. A fair bit. Especially if you're playing the FBA. You can kill them if there's a side tower even. No problem. Anyway, let me just check if I've got. That's all the tanks down. I'm gonna turn back to base. I can still tank the dogfight. Because there's no enemies, no new players, I guess. I guess I left. My team's got full zombie. Well, there's one player with a few kills. Americans is always easy to play the other nations. You know, keep wise and we can engage. So that basically completes my Harry in the tutorial. Something about landing the Harry's in the FE8. You don't need to fucking be told to take off and land. Because.
A little more effort goes, and victory will be ours.
The FA-8, even more so. The FA-8 is a lot harder than that VTOL. It's a lot harder than VTOL comparing. And it doesn't have forward veteran nozzles. So the best way to land it is got a drag sheet, use it. It might increase throttle and landing in case you're sinking too high. That's a positive thing about these VTOLs can do. Harry is also a bit more forgiving because it's got a wider wheelbase thanks to the wheels and the wheels. And he also has a gun pot underneath the plane, which is down to the crash. You activate if you crash and you down the engine, you're kind of fucked. Granted, they did make the damage and crashing and having damage engine not as bad, so instead of losing, you know, if you're just in a thrust, which is detrimental for VTOL, you only lose like 5% of the thrust when your plane's orange, when your engine's orange. So that's a good thing gameplay wise, so you don't have to worry about that so much. And of course, you can bury that, that's fine as well. Sometimes it's easier. I wouldn't recommend the FPA, because the FPA does not have. Well, the gun pod in the FA is round in the bottom, and your plane will tend to flip upside down if you land in your belly or going sideways. So I'd highly do that recommend it. Anyway, that's the Harrier gameplay in a nutshell, from my perspective. I take the V8 Mighty Mouse, 76 on the British, and the UB32 pods, 64 S5K rockets on the FA.